everybody. Sammy here from the Perot Museum of Nature and Science.
And today I want to talk all about exploring our solar system.
Did you know that it's been almost 51 years since astronauts first landed on the moon? And almost 44 years since the first Mars lander, Viking 1, made it to the red planet and sent back the first colored photos from its surface. And NASA is currently planning their next mission to our red-headed neighbor with their newly named rover, Perseverance, set to launch later this year. I'm so inspired by these missions, and I'm curious, what does it take to actually get to another planet? And once we're there, what do we do? If we're headed to Mars, we first need to talk about Earth. Our planet is about 10 times the mass of Mars, and almost twice the size and diameter. In order for a rocket to get off of Earth and on its way next door, well, we gotta go really fast. Try this experiment at home with me, and let's find out why. This water balloon is our rocket, and you and me, we're the Earth. As I toss the rocket into the sky, gravity just pulls it right back down, so we gotta speed things up a bit. Now, I can't throw that fast, so instead, this 5-foot string is gonna act as gravity, and we're gonna start to spin, in hopes that our rocket can overcome Earth's gravitational pull. Our rocket is now moving fast enough to get off the surface, but now we're stuck in orbit, just like the International Space Station. But remember, we gotta get to Mars. Time to get spinning even faster, but be careful, don't get too dizzy. Now make sure to keep your eyes on the rocket. Whoa, did you see that? Our rocket reached the speed it needed to escape Earth's orbit, or more formally known as the escape velocity. So once we finally land on Mars, now what? NASA scientists are looking for all sorts of stuff on this planet. Water, resources, and even evidence of life, just to name a few. But how do we actually do that? Satellite images of Mars' surface help us look for landforms that may have formed from flowing liquid water, and we can observe and model these processes right here on Earth. Do you notice any familiar features starting to form? Once we take the water away, we can start to see these features a little clearer. You notice these channels that have been carved into my soil. Do we see anything similar on the surface of Mars? Now, rovers can help us learn a lot about another planet. They'll drill holes into the surface to determine what minerals are hiding inside of the rocks. We know that on Earth, some types of minerals only form in the presence of liquid water, and some types of minerals contain elements that are necessary ingredients for life. So these robotic geologists are helping us figure out if any of those minerals are also on Mars. Other private industries are even looking beyond rovers and planning to get humans onto the surface of Mars in the not-so-distant future. What? Did the green shrubs give it away? Okay, you caught me. This is my friend Tim. He's already practicing. Sign him up, NASA. My friend Catherine is gonna help us get back to Earth. Our rocket on Mars is experiencing only 40% of the gravitational pull that it did on Earth, or in this case, only a 2-foot long string. So our rocket will reach its escape velocity of Mars, moving a lot slower. Well, that was fun, you guys. Think you have what it takes to be a Martian? Let us know, and we'll see you next time when we get to amaze our brains together from, well, whatever planet you call home.